Today, we've got a reveal of Minecraft and Modern Warfare 3 multiplayer pro tips.
Plus, the best-looking game on the iPad and why you should watch UFC on your Xbox 360. XPlay starts right now.
Hello and welcome to XPlay. Haters gonna hate.
Yeah.
I'm Adam Sessler.
And I'm Morgan Webb. Indeed, haters gonna hate.
Coming up, we'll shoot down UAVs, tag enemies, and show you how to make the most of your precious double XP time in Modern Warfare 3 multiplayer. Then, a look at the incredibly well-made iPad game Infinity Blade 2. We'll talk swipes and stabs with creator Donald Mustard.
Plus, we'll show you how to become rich and successful. That's because Insomniac CEO Ted Price will reveal the secrets to his success, which you can then copy. And later, find out why you'll be playing fewer games on your Xbox when we take an in-depth look at the huge new dashboard update.
But first, it's time to level up.
Mountain Dew's Modern Warfare 3 Double XP promotion will have you unlocking gear and prestiging in no time.
All you have to do is buy a specially marked Mountain Dew or Mountain Dew Game Fuel. Find the code under the cap and enter it at DewXP.com.
That Double XP time is not going to last forever, though. You've got to make the most of it, and these pro tips will definitely help.
Double XP is more precious than a piece of Sauron's jewelry, so don't waste it. If you want to dominate with Double XP, put down the guns and pick up a recon drone.
Remote recon drone standing by.
The recon drone is one of the best ways to make the most of your Double XP stash. This little copter is an XP juggernaut. And unless you're one of those maniacs who's dropping Moabs, your tag death ratio is guaranteed to be a lot higher than your kill death ratio. Tag, you're it.
Friendly recon drone inbound.
Plus, every time one of the guys you tagged gets killed, you get more XP. Even after your bird has landed, you'll keep racking up the assist points. But wait, there's more. Every time you tag an enemy, it's like you're hitting them in the face with a flashbang, making them easy targets for your teammates. And that makes winning the game and collecting even more XP that much easier. Another way to grab some easy double XP is to carry a launcher as your second weapon and shoot down anything that flies. The best thing about a firefight with a UAV is that it doesn't shoot back. Taking out a helicopter with double XP will do more than give you hundreds of points in one shot. It'll give your team a better chance to win. With no UAV giving away your team's positions, no helicopters raining death from above, and your recon drone tagging people like your Banksy, you've doubled more than your XP. You just doubled your team's chances of winning.
Victory. Good work, comrades.
Minecraft has been on sale for 2 years now, but what you bought was an alpha or a beta. Now, the game worked fine, but it wasn't technically finished. But that changed at the recent Minecraft convention when Notch, the game's creator, pulled an official-looking Switch and released version 1.0. And that makes it review-worthy.
The wait is finally over. After 2 years of development in a lengthy open beta, the final version of Minecraft has arrived. Minecraft is already an industry phenomenon for very good reason. Building, crafting, and adventuring doesn't get much better than this. You have to admire its indie spirit. Minecraft's procedurally generated landscape and resources provide limitless possibilities. For a game comprised solely of blocks, Minecraft is a beautiful creation. The blocky design is uncommon in today's realism-obsessed industry, but that's what gives the game its charm. There's no room for blank page syndrome when you've got a whole biosphere in front of you. With so many creation algorithms, climate changes, and various terrains to play with, you'll find yourself mindfully constructing an intricate world you can call your own. Building is the game's most obvious hook, and while great works require great effort, be thankful the UI doesn't get in the way. No clunky pop-up menus and selection wheels here. You can do a lot in Minecraft with just two clicks. One to pull blocks into your inventory, and another to spit them back out. And while Minecraft may feel like a massive Lego set, it's also an engrossing survival game. At nighttime, your pristine cube world will be invaded by monster spiders and exploding creepers, so you must either hide or fight to save yourself and your land. The lack of traditional plot, map, or story may provide for a more open experience, but there's no official documentation to guide you through it. If you want to figure everything out yourself, well, best of luck to you. But if you look online, you risk having all the secrets revealed by clicking the wrong link. Some kind of minimal tutorial introduction would have been nice. Minecraft is highly addictive and has that I have to explore just one more cavern or build one more railroad line vibe that makes it almost impossible to put down. What you get out of this game is entirely up to you. Minecraft gets 5 block stacks out of 5.
Coming up, we're going to do something that's always informative and hurtful. Read your questions from the XPlay inbox. Plus, the creator of the hit iOS game Infinity Blade 2 explains what's changed in the sequel. Insomniac's Ted Price reveals why he's so damn successful and so handsome. And we'll take you inside the new and improved Xbox 360. We'll be right back.
This portion of XPlay is fueled by Mountain Dew. Life is better with Mountain Dew Double XP, so rank up for Modern Warfare 3. Just get your hands on some Mountain Dew, find the code, and go to DewXP.com. Enter the code and watch that sweet, sweet XP come rolling in. It's Mountain Dew's rank up experience. Call of Duty Modern Warfare 3 Double XP and other prizes available at DewXP.com.
Last year, Epic Games and Chair Entertainment teamed up to release Infinity Blade. It was one of the first major iOS releases to combine sophisticated visuals with gameplay that actually worked. Infinity Blade 2 is even bigger and better.
Give me a sword. Fight me.
I think it was the right time for Epic to demonstrate the potential of what one of these handheld games could be. You know, to really take this amazing technology and apply it to the handheld space.
Both the original and its sequel used the Unreal Engine to generate high-fidelity imagery.
And we kind of always want to push Unreal Engine 3 wherever it makes sense, and not just on Xbox 360, but on all viable platforms.
Riches, women, and power would be yours.
Players guide the main character through a beautiful 3D world, complete with epic fights and swipe-based fighting segments.
Infinity Blade 2 is awesome. It really takes a lot of the core gameplay that was so refined and so compelling and so addictive in the first game and just broadens that to the next level. Infinity Blade 2 is an amazing experience.
Infinity Blade 2 is available now for your iPhone, iPod Touch, or iPad.
Chair should subtitle that game Thigh Melter, because your phone gets so hot when you're in the bathroom and then, you know, you put it down. Oh, sorry, Morgan and Adam. Going to something else. Speaking of fancy iOS games, I got an iPad. Sure, you can play Infinity Blade 2 on it, but you know what's more fun? Reading what's in the XPlay inbox. All right, our first email comes from Josh. He's got a question about a cool show. He writes, "Hey, do you guys watch My Little Pony Friendship? Do you watch My Little Pony Friendship is Magic?
How did you know?" You know, yeah.
Yeah, okay, so here's the thing. They're laughing and pretending they're all cool, but Adam and Blair are bronies. It's true.
Well, yes, but let's be fair, because I'm a bigger fan of My Big Pony. It's a German video series.
My Big Pony means something different to certain people, Adam. Next, Dylan asks, what did you think of the trailer for Grand Theft Auto 5?
I liked it.
I thought it was pretty cool. Yeah. I mean, we're not going to see that game for a while, and it is sort of the classic teaser trailer, so you know, reserving judgment, of course.
Well, I didn't expect it to look as much like Los Angeles as it actually did.
Yeah.
And given my frustrations of not knowing the road layout in New York City for four, I feel like finally they're thinking about me. So that's that. Thank you.
I'm sure they did it for Adam.
I really look forward to stealing a car and then waiting in traffic while the cops catch me. Stan wants to address a hot button issue. Why can you only marry around 50 people in Skyrim and none of them are Khajiit or a wood elf?
I only recently realized that you could get married in the game.
Right, well, because you have to get the special charm, so you can't just go out and get married.
Also, if you saw my character, he's going to lead a solitary life.
But it seems like our friend wants to marry a lot of people. Maybe he's lonely.
You know, maybe he wants, you know, some of that kind of, hey, I'm a tiger, but I'm bipedal action.
So I think what you should do is you should write to Bethesda and tell them that 50 is not enough people to marry and tell them how many people you think is appropriate, and maybe they'll put it into the next game.
I want to marry a big pony.
Actually, people in Utah agree with both of you on that one. And finally, Josh writes, out of all the great games that came out this year, it's a tough question, which one's your favorite?
Yeah, we're not going to spill the beans yet.
No. So Wednesday at 6 is our 1-hour-long Best of 2011 special, and at that point we'll get a ton of awards, and then you will find out what our favorite games of the year are. We don't tell you first.
No, and Adam and I are going to wear nice shoes. It's going to be awesome. Viewers, thank you, as always, for all of your questions. Remember, you can ask us the obvious, too. Just send the correspondence to xplay@g4tv.com.
All right, after the break, we're going to find out why Insomniac's Ted Price is so successful and then reveal all of his secrets.
All of his secrets, because he has like three.
Yeah.
Plus, everything you need to know about the new and improved Xbox experience.
But first, here is this month's Release Radar brought to you by Gamefly.
Welcome back. This holiday season, you can be a selfish bastard and still
PS3 and an Xbox 360 and donating all of the proceeds to Child's Play.
Now, the charity, which was created by Penny Arcade, will then take that cash and buy toys and games for kids in over 70 hospitals around the country.
It is a great charity, and we donate every year. As of 2010, they've raised almost $10 million.
But back to the console.
Yes.
Because this is no ordinary auction. They've each been autographed by some of the industry's biggest names. Ken Levine, Todd Howard, Nolan North, David Jaffe. We even got Coltrane and Ice-T to sign them.
If you want more info and are interested in bidding, just go to g4tv.com/childsplay. And don't wait, the auction ends on December 21st.
All right.
Okay.
I hate Ted Price. Here's why.
Okay.
He's tall.
Mm-hmm.
He's handsome. And he runs one of the best video game studios around.
And don't forget about the great hair. That's been verified by Fortune magazine and the government. Insomniac is an amazing place to work.
So if you want to be 1/10, 1/100th as successful as this guy, maybe you should listen to the secrets of his success. While creating an amazing game is a great achievement, running one of the most successful gaming companies in the business is a feat in itself. We sat down with founder and president of Insomniac Games, Ted Price, to find out the philosophy behind their secrets of success.
We tend to talk about three things that make Insomniac who it is. Everyone contributes, we try to raise the bar with everything we do, and we ship on time every time. Those are three important aspects of who we are. Having been around for 17 years, we've learned quite a bit about what it takes to create an effective team effort.
There are no divas in the Insomniac office, including Ted, and that's what helps Insomniac stick to their main goal, which is making great games.
Collaboration absolutely is king. Our ideas come from all corners of the company. It's not me coming up with the ideas. It's not our creative directors or lead designers necessarily. We ask people to talk about things that they like and suggest game ideas or weapon ideas or story ideas. And as a result, I think we got a lot of variety within our games. We're always saying, how can we make something that's fresh? Or in the case of an existing franchise that we've created, how can we make the sequel different than the previous one? And that in itself is a real challenge too.
Insomniac prides themselves on their ability to take gamers to worlds they've never seen before.
We built the Ratchet and Resistance universes as these non-realistic places so that we could push what was believable and what wasn't believable, basically. When people think about the gameplay, Insomniac's games, I think the number one thing they'll point to are the weapons. And also the gadgets. And I think there's a distinction there. But we've had both weapons and gadgets throughout the Ratchet games. And of course, we focus heavily on weapons in Resistance. But for us, that's really an opportunity to be super creative. And it's fun at Insomniac just to let loose with crazy ideas.
And it's Ted's desire to work with a younger generation that will help build on Insomniac's future success.
I'm Gen X. I'm 43, and I've been working in games for almost 2 decades. Today at Insomniac, we have a lot of folks who are coming in who are Gen Y, who are just getting into the industry and have completely different cultural influences than I do or I did when I started in games. And I think finding the mesh between the Gen Xers and the Gen Ys has been a fascinating journey at Insomniac.
Coming up, find out why you'll start watching UFC on your Xbox 360 instead of going to the bar and starting fights with whoever looks at you funny. We'll be right back.
Now bring it.
Welcome back. Remember what the Xbox 360 dashboard looked like at launch? It was orange, and it had magical blades that went back and forth. That's it. Today, the console's been redesigned and turned into an entertainment system with live TV, social networking, and integration with the UFC. I got all the details about the latest update straight from Microsoft. Sure, you'll hike thousands of miles in Skyrim, but the trip that's hardest to make is the 4 feet in the real world from your couch to the remote to change the input. Well, the forces of laziness have found their own BFG in Microsoft's brand new dashboard update. I sat down with Ross Honey, General Manager of Xbox Live Entertainment and Advertising, to talk about it.
In time, when you want to sit down and play a game, watch a great movie, or listen to some music, you're going to go to Xbox.
Streaming video is nothing new to the Xbox, but the video licensing elves over at Microsoft have been hard at work.
We've announced 40 new partners coming to the platform. Great companies like YouTube, like Comcast, like HBO.
New licenses coming next year include BBC, UFC, TMZ, Major League Baseball, and The Daily Motion. And expansions on previous content like the ESPN app let you name favorite sports and teams, allowing you to create your own private sports center. With all this content, Microsoft is ready to break out of its box. So let's talk about the Kinect commands, because I think we've been waiting a long time to have that 100% Kinect integrated voice command functionality.
Everything in the user interface is Kinect enabled. So whether that's by gesture or whether that's by voice, you can now browse through the entire Xbox platform using Kinect.
Xbox. Bing the office.
My favorite thing is search. When you're trying to find that movie or TV show that you want to watch, it's a lot of work to go from app to app to app trying to find that content. So to bring that all in one place and provide that unified content search, it's just magical and it's so fast.
But the newest and coolest features are strictly for gamers. Say you're sitting at home, sad, lonely, nobody's online, you don't have any, everyone's playing some other game. How do you solve this sad conundrum that you're in?
We have great news for you. We're implementing something we call beacons. So you come online, and by activating a beacon saying, hey, I want to play Gears of War with somebody, and you can now post that out to Facebook. And so even if, God forbid, some of your friends are not on Xbox at that time.
Oh, right? Awful.
I know, it's a tragedy. If they're on Facebook, on the web, or on their phone, they're going to see that beacon, and they're going to make a beeline to their Xbox to play with you.
Cloud storage makes its entry into the Xbox as well in this update.
Once you play it at home and do a save and then go to your friend's house, it's all up there in cloud. Also with cloud saves, account recovery is a thing of the past. Now it's all in the cloud, so you can go to your friend's house anytime and pull down your profile as well as your saves.
Well, thank you very much.
Thank you.
I think the lesson here today is don't fear change. Embrace it.
As you can see, the Xbox 360 has come a long way since those blades.
Yes, and I don't miss them. Now they've actually made this really sort of multimedia experience with this new update. I mean, it makes sense to actually get that content that people are paying extra for, get it into your home for all those people who already have the Xbox.
And it's the Trojan horse. I think they've always tried to make the Xbox, even with the original one. Remember, it had a very large hard drive with no reason to have that. That, you know, they knew there was a way that you could turn it into something more than a game machine, but get it into the house as a game machine. And I think what works to their advantage is the interface is so easy to use. If you've tried to teach your TiVo to your parents, you understand how good the Xbox's interface is.
But so we'll see how the content evolves, because I know that there's a lot of issues with, like, you know, maybe some cable companies don't want to put all their content on there. They're trying to figure out a revenue model so that everybody actually gets, you know, compensated for their content, which we obviously think is fair. So we'll see how that sort of manages and ramps up. But I think it's great. We already have ESPN on there. We get all the, you know, college football games right there.
I mean, it's going to have to happen, not just with the Xbox, with something like Apple TV, with all these other devices. It's just kind of forcing this issue, and it has to get resolved.
Also, cloud saves. Love it. Okay, well, here's a look at what's coming up on XPlay while we think about our cloud saves. Tomorrow, we've got more Modern Warfare 3 pro tips that'll score you all the XP you need. Plus, don't miss the new trailer for the highly anticipated BioShock Infinite and our review of the game that might make you buy a Nintendo 3DS, Super Mario 3D Land.
Plus the always peppy MMO report.
And of course, we get to see more BioShock Infinite, which is always a treat.
I can always see more of that.
Yes, until the game comes out.
One day. After all, I think I'll see more.
Thanks for watching X Plus.